Everyone involved in First Deck Challenge is familiar with the field tiles, but we don't often spend much time thinking about them. Let's change that. Before we dive in, I need to say that if you're looking for legal field tiles for the First Deck Challenge, there is one place for you to go, and that's AndyMark. If you buy tiles from any other manufacturer, you run the risk of affecting your robot's performance, so keep that in mind. If you were at the 2023 First Championship, you may be aware that there were some issues with the competition field tiles. They were just a little bit smaller than normal. And while the size difference wasn't that major on a per tile basis, once you got the full field laid out, there were some noticeable gaps on the edges of the field, so much so that it wasn't necessary to cut the teeth on the edge of the tiles quite as much as we're used to. I believe that AndyMark are working on the problem, and a set of tiles that I got more recently in June of 2023 didn't quite have that same size issue, but they do still warn that there is some variation in the tiles, and especially if you're buying multiple sets of tiles across different years, you may find that they're not quite as compatible as we're used to. This isn't a new problem. This also happened with the soft tiles that we used to buy back in the day. Different batches throughout different years would have slightly different colors or slightly different sizes, and we'd have to deal with those once we got to the competition field. All of this got me thinking, what options are available to teams? So let's meet the candidates, and first up is a set of four soft tiles that I took from my local league's set. These are, I'm going to estimate, about 5 years old, and they are showing their age for sure. It doesn't really show up on camera, but there are definite robot tire marks, some puncture holes and everything like that. But I went through and I chose four of the tiles that were showing the least amount of damage from that set so that we could have as best of a comparison to the new tiles as possible. But we do have to keep in mind that these are used, they are going to perform differently as a result. Next up, I bought a set of four AndyMark tiles in June of 2023. These are sort of the control group. They are the legal First Deck Challenge tiles, the ones you should buy if you're not sure what you want to get. They are brand new, so they look very nice, and we're going to damage them a little bit throughout this testing. Finally, we have a set of four Vex brand anti-static tiles. These are a bit different, also brand new and looking pretty good, but they are different in the sense that they are a bit lighter and they are double-sided. There's no rough backing like you get with the soft tiles or the AndyMark tiles, so you could potentially take the full set of tiles and flip the entire field in a few years and maybe get some more use out of them. At least, we'll see. The Vex anti-static tiles are particularly interesting to me because they are double-sided, so potentially you could get double the use out of them, and they have a material inside of the foam that helps to spread out any electrical charges that build up over time. Electrostatic discharge is a continuous issue with First Deck Challenge, especially in the winter months when things get more dry, and robots tend to have more problems with static buildup. Anything that can help to disperse that issue is very interesting to me as an FTA, so I wanted to take a look at them. So these are the three tiles that I have to compare. Let's take a look at some of the basic physical characteristics to get started. We'll start with the length. And to get an idea of the length of the tiles, I put all four tiles together and measured the total length so that any differences would be magnified across the four tiles instead of trying to find small differences on a per tile basis. The original soft tiles came in at around 93¼ inches for all four tiles. The AndyMark and the Vex, on the other hand, came in closer to 93½ inches, and they were very close between the two of them. We should note that the AndyMark tiles are experiencing some difference in sizing, so if you order a batch, you may get something slightly different. Although this may be an issue that they are working on or completely solved at this point, I'm not aware of any changes. Next up is the thickness of the tiles, and there's no major variation between them. I remember a few years back, we got a set of soft tiles here in Florida that were much thinner than the rest, and this created problems because you would get lips on the field where robots would catch on the edge of a tile. There's nothing like that in this set. The Vex tiles do come out as the thickest, which is interesting considering the weight that we'll consider next. Weight is where we do start to see some major variation between the tiles. The soft tiles end up right in the middle of the batch, at around 432 grams on average per tile. The AndyMark tiles are the heaviest, at 530 grams per tile on average, and the VEX ended up being the lightest at more like 358 grams. This is interesting considering that the VEX tiles are the thickest of the lot, and they're not much smaller size-wise. So it just goes to show that there is a different material at play. The different type of foam has a different density. And while we don't normally think of the weight of the tile as something that matters for the competition field, because it's sitting on the floor after all, it's not like robots have to lift it, it is something you have to consider if you are transporting those tiles to competitions constantly. So FTAs might want to look out for this if you are going to a scrimmage event and you don't want to have to carry two large heavy bags of tiles. We're going to get into some more contrived tests related to compression and other things in a minute, but just to wrap up some of the more obvious physical characteristics of the tiles, with the VEX anti-static tiles, again, we have that double-sided nature of them. So while this does not mean that you can take a single tile out of the set and flip it because the teeth are going to be going in the wrong direction, what you can do is after a few years of use, you can take the full set of tiles and flip all of them and hopefully get a few more years of use out of them, potentially saving you a lot of money. On the other hand, the anti-mark tiles are more classic like we're used to, where the back is this rough material, which depending on where you are practicing may be a benefit to you to keep the field from sliding around if you don't have a field perimeter. Both the anti-mark and the VEX tiles have some minor holes in the surface of the tiles, even when they come new. Nothing major to report there, and I didn't have any significant issues with any of the tiles that I received from any of the batches. Another basic characteristic of these tiles is the color, and I'm going to leave the old soft tiles out of this comparison because, frankly, the tiles that I have are probably just dirty, and that accounts for most of the difference in color. Between the VEX and the anti-mark, the VEX tiles are slightly more blue, more of a bluish gray, and the anti-mark are more of the traditional reddish gray that we're used to, but frankly, you can only tell under certain lighting conditions, and if you have a consistent set across the whole field, no one is going to notice a difference between them. Finally, let's talk about the compatibility between these sets of tiles, because each tile has the same teeth pattern. Unless you're taking the VEX anti-static tile and flipping it upside down, in which case the teeth are going in the wrong direction. But it may be tempting to think that you can use these sets of tiles together. And not quite. They are a little bit different in the way that the teeth are arranged on the edge of the tile. So you're going to get some gaps in the teeth, and these are the kinds of things that robots may catch on, and it may affect robot performance if you do this. But in a pinch, if you are an FTA and you just need to get robots playing on the field and all you have is a replacement tile from a different set, you can still use it and you will be okay for the day. But if you are buying a set of tiles, be sure they are the ones you want. Commit to a particular set, and I recommend getting some extras of that kind for when you need them in the future. So that covers all of the basic physical characteristics of the tiles, but I wanted to get more of a feel for how the tiles are actually going to perform in real life without spending the next few years testing them out. So I devised a series of rather unscientific tests that we'll go through that try to mimic how robots are going to interact with the tiles over time. Let's take a look. First, I wanted to see how the tiles would respond to compression. Whether this is compression from a robot sitting on them or some game element that might be putting a lot of weight on the same tile over time. So I devised a test where we took two weights, one 25 pounds and one 50 pounds, and put them on the tiles for a certain amount of time and measured how the tiles bounced back from that compression over a series of 2, 4, and 12 hours. Let's take a look at the results. Overall, the anti-mark tiles performed the best. They had the least amount of compression at the end of 12 hours, and they seemed to bounce back the fastest. All of the tiles still have some compression marks on them, but frankly, they're all still usable, and I don't see any major problems with any of them. And in case you're confused by the numbers, I just want to note that while the 50-pound weight was heavier, it was spread out over a larger surface area on the tile itself, so there was a bit less compression from it. Next, I wanted to see how the tiles would perform in terms of abrasion against the surface. So what I did was I took some coarse sandpaper and I made several swipes against the surface of the tile in order to see how it would change visually and in terms of feel. With the older soft tiles, you can barely feel any difference in the surface, but you can see a change in the color. With the anti-mark tiles, the change is less visible and you can barely feel any difference. On the vex tiles, the change is a little more visible, but there's practically no change at all in the feel. Along similar lines, I wanted to see if there were any major differences in terms of the friction on the surface of the tile. So what I did was I took a large flat surface and I dragged it across the tile using one of these spring force gauges you may be familiar with from high school physics class. And being an FTA, I always have some gaffer tape on hand, so I added a little more weight to that surface just to make sure that we were getting some good measurements. I expected the older SoftTiles to require a bit more force to pull the surface across because they're older and the surface is a bit more rough. And that is indeed what happened. It required about 10 newtons of force, as measured by this spring force gauge, to pull that surface across the old SoftTile. And I want to note that I'm trying to get a measure of the force while the surface is in motion. Effectively, I'm more interested in the dynamic coefficient of friction than the static coefficient of friction here, because robots tend to be on the move, and that's the type of friction they're going to experience more on this tile. Next up, the Andymark tile required the least amount of force to pull the surface across. But you'll notice that it was a bit bouncy, meaning there is a larger difference between the static and the dynamic friction coefficients for this tile. This is also probably just an aspect of the tile being newer. When we get to the vex tile, we get some interesting results. It actually takes, again, 10 newtons of force, the same as the older soft tile, to pull this surface across. This is just interesting because it means that that anti-static foam material has a bit more grip to it, and it could potentially affect the performance of robots, but I suspect that the effect on the performance is less than if you took a non-anti-static tile and applied something like staticide to it, which is the current recommended way to mitigate electrostatic discharge. So there's more testing to be done here. Moving on to the way that I see tiles damaged the most is by puncturing from robot parts, edges of materials, whatever the case may be. So I devised a test where I took a series of drill bits of various sizes and I put a weight on top of them so that they would compress into the foam and we could see how the compression and puncturing would change depending on the size of the bit. And there's not much to report here. As expected, the old soft tiles took more damage than the newer tiles. They have a rougher surface and they've been stepped on plenty. So I'm not surprised that the drill bits compressed in a bit more, especially on the small end. When it comes to the vex versus the Andymark tiles, I see no real difference and there was nothing major to report there. There's just one more test I want to do, and it's to test the interaction between these tiles and gaffer tape, since this is something we're constantly putting on and off of the tiles. Starting with the old soft tiles, I'm just going to peel this tape off, and there's a bit of a tug. There's definitely some adhesion there still, and there's not really any marking that I can see, so at least with this older tile, not much to report there. Moving on to the Andymark tile. This is going to probably take a little bit more effort to get off just because the tile is newer and the tape probably adhere to it a bit better. And indeed, there is sort of this nice, interesting pattern on the tile that I didn't really notice before. It has sort of this checkerboard pattern, and it seems like the adhesion of the tape is a bit different depending on which spot it's hitting. Again, not really any noticeable marking on the tile itself, so that works out pretty well. And we'll finish up with the vex anti-static tile. Just take this tape off here. Again, a newer tile, so I'm expecting it to take a little more effort to get it off. Not too bad though. I'd say that's actually easier than either of the two tiles. And again, no real noticeable mark from any of them. So nothing too much to report there. Sorry it's not more interesting, but it's a good thing that the tape is easy to get on and off without damaging the tiles because that's something we do very often. Putting this all together, what do I recommend? Well, as I said at the beginning, if you're looking for a legal set of First Tech Challenge tiles, there's one place for you to go, and that's Andymark. If you go with any other manufacturer, you are making a deliberate choice to go outside of what is legal and recommended, and you should have good reasons for doing so. Now, in my opinion, those reasons do exist. For example, as someone who is responsible for spending money that ultimately comes from teams, the team dues for our local league, I want to make the most out of that money. Knowing that there's an option like the vex anti-static tiles out there, that have that double-sided feature so that in 3 to 4 years we can flip the entire field and use them as new, that's very compelling. Because although field tiles are not the most expensive thing that we spend money on as a league, I want to be financially responsible with team dues. As an FTA, I'm also interested in mitigating electrostatic discharge. This is an issue that has been with First Tech Challenge for a while, and it's something that affects the performance of the robots, but is largely not under the control of the students building the robots. It shouldn't be a factor in robot performance. So knowing that there is an option that can help mitigate that and help all of the robots equally perform better is very compelling to me. Now, if you have been around First Tech Challenge and other robotics-related forums recently, you may be aware that there have been some posts alleging that the VEX workplace and company is not the greatest place to work and there are some issues there. I don't know anything about that, and I definitely don't have any inside knowledge of what's going on at VEX, whether things have been bad, improved, or otherwise. But this is something that I just want to note so that you can keep it in mind when you're making your purchasing decisions. Between this, any financial responsibility that you have, and any responsibility that you feel for buying the correct legal components when you're constructing a field, there is a lot to consider. You won't notice any major performance differences between each type of tile, so it really comes down to that double-sided feature and the anti-static feature of the VEX tiles. I hope that AndyMark is able to resolve their current variation in size issue, and I also dream that they will introduce their own double-sided tiles and anti-static tiles in the future. I know that First is very cautious about forcing people to pay money for something new. However, I believe that this type of product and these features will ultimately save people money and improve robot performance overall in the long run. I hope that you enjoyed this comparison of the field tiles and that you got something out of it for your next purchase. If there's anything you're curious about with any of the sets of tiles, please let me know and I'll try to answer it in the future. In the meantime, I'll see you at the field.